Good morning, children. Today we are going to start chapter 8 from the book Behind. The name of the chapter is Reach for the Top. So, students, can you tell me the name of the woman who has scaled Mount Everest for the first time? Indian woman. Yes, it is Bichendri Pal. Bichendri Pal is the first Indian woman who has scaled Mount Everest for the first time. And is there any other woman in India who has scaled Mount Everest twice? It's Santosh Yadav is the only mountaineer in India who has scaled Mount Everest twice. So students, the chapter Reach for the Top, it is divided into two parts, and both the parts describe about the woman who conquered the world despite the hurdles which came in their way and reached at the top of the world. And in the first part, we will talk about Santosh Yadav. Santosh Yadav, she was the first Indian mountaineer who scaled Mount Everest twice. So let's talk about her early life. Santosh Yadav's early life. Students, Santosh was born in a family, in a rich family in Rewari district in Haryana. And at that time, the birth of girls was not welcomed in the society. But before her birth, a holy man who was about to give his blessings to her mother for a son. But at the same time, her grandmother, she insisted that they wanted a girl, not a son, they wanted a girl. And even the girls were not welcomed at that time, but their family, because they already had 5 sons. Now they wanted a girl. And after her birth, they had given her the name Santosh, means contentment. Means they were fully satisfied with the birth of a girl. That's why they had given her the name Santosh. Different from other girls, students, starting from the birth, she was different from the other girls in her village. She used to wear shorts while the other girls of her age used to wear traditional dresses like sari and many other. But she used to wear shorts and she went to school for study. Santosh, education and her dream. Santosh, even though she belonged to a rich family, but she was sent to a school in the village hall. But she wanted to study, to do higher study, and she had taken admission in a city without the permission of her parents. And then when she took the admission in the college in Jaipur, at her hostel room, as her hostel room faced the Aravali Hills, and she used to watch the people, those who were climbing on the mountains. And she became excited. She became excited to see them. At that time, she decided to climb the mountains. So one day she went there and she granted permission from a group of climbers if she could join. And they agreed and they encouraged her to climb the mountain. So students, after that she had taken admission in Uttarakashi Institute of Mountaineers. But without the permission of her parents. After that, she wrote a letter to her parents and apologized also. Because she had taken the admission without the permission of her parents. So students, a remarkable climber, as she was a remarkable climber and she had scaled the Mount Everest in the year 1992. 2 when she was only 20 years old. So students, she made a record of climbing the mountain at the youngest age in India when she was only 20 years old. And her physical stamina as well as her mental toughness helped her a lot, because these were the necessary things for climbing the mountains. So students, dream comes true. Her only dream was to climb the mountain. It became true, but within a year she had scaled the Mount Everest twice. Means in May 1993 she has scaled Mount Everest again, and at that time she also helped her fellow climber Mohan Singh, sharing her oxygen with him. A true environmentalist. Students, as you know, her determination and strong willpower helped her a lot to climb the mountain. So when she went there, she shared her feeling that unfurling the tricolor at the top of the world was an indescribable moment for her. And she when she came back from the mountain, she brought 500 kilogram garbage from Himalayas. That's why she was called a true environmentalist. So for her, these kind of activities and for her records maintained in India, she got honorable award from Indian government, Padma Shri. So students, now come to part 2, Maria Sharapova. From the same chapter 8, Reach for the Top. Maria Sharapova, she is the woman who attained top position in the world in women's tennis. So students, this story motivates one to achieve one's dreams and overcome the obstacles in one's life. Maria Sharapova, she is the brightest star of tennis. She is a fashion icon also, style icon also. She has a great sense of fashion. She loves to dance, sing and to read also. She reads novels also. So let's talk about her life in detail. Maria attains top position. Students, Maria attained the top position in women's tennis in the whole world when she was hardly 18 years old. And she attained this position in the year 2005. And it took her only 4 years to achieve her dream. Students, it was her dream to reach the top of the world, and it took her only 4 years. So you can imagine how determined she could be. And she was sent to America for the formal training of tennis when she was only 9 years old. Training in America. When she was only 9 years old, her father sent her for the training in America. Although she was born and brought up in Russia, but for the formal training of tennis, her father and they went to America. And she had to live separate from her mother for 2 years, as her mother's visa got refused. And she could not go along with that. Now she had to live separate from her mother. Tough times make her strong. Students, she felt lonely. She felt lonely at that time because she was very young, and even all the athletes, they were elder from her. She was the youngest of all. She was the youngest of all the athletes in the room. They made her tidy up and clean the room. and at that time she missed her mother badly. But she learned so much from them. She learned how to take care of herself. And her motto in the life, to achieve her goal at any cost. And this motto made her to attain this success in life. As she lived in America, but she was Russian from heart. Because she was a true patriot and she wanted to play in Olympics for Russia if the country allowed her to play. And from this it shows clearly that she was a true patriot of Russia. Although United States had played an important role in her life, she took all the training in United States, but from heart, she was a Russian. Hobbies and interests of Maria. Students, Maria loves singing, dancing, music, and even reading. She reads the novels of Arthur Campbell. She has a great sense of fashion also. And eating habits. If we talk about her eating habits, she loves to eat pancakes, chocolates and orange treats. So students, if we talk about her life, she took money as a motivation, but her dream was to achieve her dream, to reach the top of the world, and it becomes true with her strong will and determination. So students, the chapter Reach for the Top, it describes the life of two women who conquered the world despite hurdles in their life.